In this example, you will learn how to pick up item and add it to the player. I will be showing it at gold and adding its amount to the player. If you have any problem getting something working, feel free to check out previous part of this series. So, go to the third person character blueprint. Add new variable, name it gold, and change it to float. I want to do every change of character's variable by function in its blueprint. Create new function and name it change gold amount. Drag in get and set of gold variable. Add input parameter, change it to float and rename it to amount of gold. Drag out input pin and search for add by writing plus sign. Connect get gold to another pin and connect its output to set gold. Players should be also able to see amount of gold they have, so go to the HUD widget blueprint. Here, scroll down and under panel, search for horizontal box and drag it in. Scale it up a bit and drag in text block 2 times. To the first one, just change text to gold colon space. To the second one, change default text to 0, rename it to TB underscore gold and check it as variable. Move the graph, create new function and name it set gold amount. Drag in reference to our TB gold. Out of it, search for set text and select the highlighted option under content. Add input. Rename it to gold amount and change it to float. Connect its pin to text, which will do automatic data type conversion. Compile and go back to the third person character blueprint. If we want to show the current amount of gold at any time, we need to update it with every change. So, drag in HUD reference and out of it search for our new function setGoldAmount. Connect it after set and connect its output pin with gold amount pin. Hit compile and all we need now is an item to pick up. Go to interactable objects folder and create new actor. Because it's gold we want to pick up, name it bb underscore pickable gold and open it. Under components add static mesh. And under its static mesh option, search for shape cylinder. This will represent our very big and ugly gold coin. But not that big, so scale it down. My final scale is 0.25 for X and for Y and about 0.06 for Z. Under the material option, search for gold material and select it. Add new variable, name it gold amount and change its type to float. This variable will represent the value of this item. Hit compile so we can set up default value. I set it to 20. Go to class settings, add our interface iInteractable and move the event graph. Now let's implement interface functions. Double click on them. I first implement showInfo. Drag out HUD pin and search for setInfoText. You could write right into the text field, but I use a little more advanced method. Right click and search for append. At the bottom, under string. Connect return value into text info to show. In the first one, write gold colon space. Drag in gold value reference and connect it to the B pin. I call it more advanced method because now you can just create a child of this blueprint, change the default value and maybe static mesh, and everything will show and work as you want. Let's implement the interact function. First, we need to get a reference to our third person character blueprint. Find cast the BB third person character. I convert it to pure cast. Out of object, find get player pawn. Out of cast output pin, search for change gold amount. Connect it to the start of function. Drag in gold value reference and connect it to amount of gold. After we get our gold, we want to destroy this object, so to the end, add destroy actor. Hit compile. Go to level preview and place a few gold actors into the level. Before you hit play, it's always good to save the whole project in case you did something wrong and Unreal would crash. Now hit play and test it. You can see gold is being destroyed after picking up and its value is being added to the player appropriately. Now you have basic knowledge about how to pick up items in Unreal Engine. In the last part of this series, you will learn how to interact with modular parts of your level. That's all for this video, so see you in the next one.